Blackstone Publishing presents Albert Einstein by Kathleen Krull. This book is read by Tavia Gilbert. To Cindy Clevenger and All the Rabbits, KK. Introduction. If I have seen further than other people, it is by standing upon the shoulders of giants. Isaac Newton, 1675. Albert Einstein had major bedhead. His hair looked as though he'd stuck a finger in an electrical socket. Besides being fashion-challenged, he had problems with school, women, money, memory, and day-to-day life. In the lab, things around him tended to explode. For years, no university would have anything to do with him. For years, he toiled as a clerk in a government job. But he had his charms. He became king of the snappy soundbite, always bemused, sort of cuddly, with soulful eyes. And quite rightfully, his name has become a synonym for genius. His work in physics, the science that studies the behavior of objects in motion, was revolutionary. At age 26, in 1905, this man changed the course of the world with his theory of relativity and his famous equation, E equals mc squared. Energy and matter, he said, were basically the same thing, and you could convert one into the other. It is no exaggeration to talk of a pre-Einstein and a post-Einstein world. Einstein lived in an extraordinary time. The dawn of the 20th century had a vibe similar to the Renaissance in Italy in the 15th century. Civilization seemed to take a giant leap forward. Pablo Picasso reinvented painting with fractured cubism. Sigmund Freud was charting illnesses not of the body, but of the mind. James Joyce wrote novels in a new stream of consciousness style. Arnold Schoenberg composed atonal music with no interest in conventional harmony. Questioning basic concepts in physics, Einstein jumped right in, fueled by his curiosity. "I have no special talents," he once said. "I am only passionately curious." Science was a solitary pursuit to Einstein. He liked to be alone, free to think for hours on end. In fact, he thought, half seriously, that scientists should work as lighthouse keepers so they would be totally undisturbed. But Einstein was no reclusive ivory tower genius. He had lots of help from the very beginning. Two supportive parents, one inspirational uncle. Among his best friends were brilliant scientists who loved and nourished him. He even married one of them, Mileva Maric, a fellow physics student. The Einstein family business was supplying a new technology, electricity, so towns could turn their gas lights off and glow with electric light. Einstein grew up surrounded by the latest information about using electricity, and he spent 7 years working at a patent office in Switzerland, determining whether inventions submitted were truly new or not. He was fortunate that his boss looked the other way when he pulled out his own science theories to work on. Once, with another scientist, he did invent a type of refrigerator. But newfangled gadgets that made everyday life easier weren't his passion. From his teens, Einstein was obsessed with the big, abstract questions, namely, how did the universe work? His whole aim in life, the needle on his compass, was to generalize, to unify, to link together concepts. It is a glorious feeling to discover the unity of a set of phenomena that seem at first to be completely separate. His patience was legendary. "The whole of science is nothing more than a refinement of everyday thinking," he said, no matter how long that refinement might take. After spending 10 years pondering the question of what happens at the speed of light, Einstein found his solutions. The four papers he published in 1905 revolutionized scientists' understanding of the universe. Space and time no longer meant what people thought they meant. They behaved in ways that didn't seem to agree with common sense. Scientists are still working on the implications of all he discovered. It was a miracle year for Einstein, resembling what the great Isaac Newton had experienced in 1666. During that year, Newton, a mighty thinker himself, was able to lay down the laws of motion, to understand that the force of gravity that made an apple fall to Earth was the exact same force that pulled
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.